JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFT's daily market review for December the 11th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFT, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower against all but one of the other G10 currencies on Thursday and during the Asian session Friday. It underperformed only versus the pound, while it gained the most against the Aussie, the Kiwi, NOK and the Canadian dollar in that order. The weakening of the US dollar and the strengthening of the commodity-linked Aussie, Kiwi and Loonie suggest that markets turned risk on at some point yesterday. However, taking a look at the performance of major global stock indices, we see that the picture is more of a mixed one. In the EU, the sole gainer was the FTSE 100, which gained due to the tumbling of the pound. Remember that many companies of the index generate profits in other currencies, so in a weakening GBP environment, if those profits are converted to pounds, they're worth more. In the US, the Dow Jones and the S&P 500 slid 0.23 and 0.13% respectively, but Nasdaq gained 0.54%. The somewhat soft sentiment in the US may have been the result of the US initial jobless claims spiking to 853,000, which is the highest level since mid-September. This has underscored the need for fresh stimulus measures to support the world's largest economy. That said, Wall Street came off its lows after US Treasury Secretary Steve Mnuchin said that talks between Republican and Democratic senators on COVID-19 relief were making a lot of progress, with more discussions expected in the day. That said, later in the day, House Speaker Nancy Pelosi said that wrangling over a coronavirus aid package could drag on through Christmas. Maybe that's why Asian indices were mixed as well, instead of gaining on Mnuchin's upbeat remarks. Japan's Nikkei 225 and China Shanghai Composite fell 0.39 and 0.77% respectively, while Hong Kong's Hang Seng and South Korea's KOSPI gained 0.50 and 0.86%. Now in the FX world, as we already noted, the pound was the sole loser against the US dollar, at least among the G10s, and this had to do once again with headlines surrounding Brexit. After failing to reach common ground with EU Commission President Ursula von der Leyen, UK Prime Minister Boris Johnson said yesterday that there was a strong possibility that the UK and the EU would fail to strike a trade deal. This may have sparked even more fears over the likelihood of a no-deal Brexit in 3 weeks, which is the deadline for the two sides to sign any accord. We repeat that the pound is likely to stay very sensitive to Brexit developments, with anything suggesting that the two sides finding hard to bridge their differences, having the potential to push the pound lower. For the pound to rebound, headlines that some sort of consensus is reached are needed. Now, yesterday we also had an ECB monetary policy decision, with the central bank expanding its pandemic emergency purchase program by 500 billion euros and extending the scheme by 9 months to March 2022. Although President Lagarde said at the press conference following the decision that the appreciation of the euro exercises downward pressure on prices and that they will monitor it very carefully, the common currency gained on the decision. Perhaps due to its latest rally, many people, including us, were expecting the bank to deliver more, easing. That's why the outcome may have come as a disappointment, and many traders may have closed their short positions, allowing the currency to drift higher. Now, as for today's events, Germany's final CPIs for November are expected to confirm their preliminary estimates, while in the US, the preliminary University of Michigan Consumer Sentiment Index for December is forecast to have declined fractionally to 76.5 from 76.9. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, a greater weekend, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next week.
JFT, just fair and direct.